In this video, you'll learn how to operate your electrical panel. That's starting right now.
Welcome to Home Buyer School, brought to you by Brookfield Residential.
Hi everyone, I'm Carl. Welcome to another Home Buyer School video, a channel where you get the latest strategies, tactics, and tips from home buying experts. Now remember, if this is your first time on this channel and you want to get the latest strategies from the experts, hit the subscription button below, hit the little notification bell so you don't miss anything. So today I'm joined by Josh Brinkman with Brookfield Residential, and we're going to talk about understanding your electrical panel. So Josh, what are some things we need to know, or a homeowner needs to know, about their electrical panel?
So there actually is quite a bit to go over, but the first most important one, this breaker up at the top, that is your main shutoff. If you turn that off, there's no power to the entire home. Going forward, there are breakers with white tabs on here. They're called arc fault breakers. It's a safety device that if there ever is an overabundance of power running through a circuit, it's going to simply trip the breaker and it will pop the breaker into the center position. Now you cannot turn it right back on. You have to go all the way off, all the way back on. That resets the breaker and allows it to regain power. Now that's the same for every single breaker. If any of them do trip to that center position, you need to reset it by shutting it off and then back on.
So why does the breaker trip?
So the breaker trips if there's too much power surging through that circuit. Mm-hmm. If it's too much of a load, the breaker will just turn itself off for a safety reason. If you have too much power going through, there mm-hmm. is a chance of an electric shock. This eliminates that.
Great. And obviously here you can tell which breaker is connected to which room in the house, right?
Yeah, so to identify which breaker you're wanting to shut off, you're going to have to look at the label that's on the door and reference it to the numbers that are indented on the sides. Now the numbers that are indented on the sides are very tough to see without a flashlight. So if you pull out your light and you direct it underneath, you can see that there is all the numbers indented on the sides. So say you're looking for your kitchen plugs. You're going to look on this side and you're going to see 8A, that's kitchen plugs. So you're going to go to your breaker, number 8, A is the top, B is the bottom. So you'll shut A off, then back on.
Perfect. Do you have anything else to add in terms of your electrical panel?
So there are a couple spaces you'll see on your electrical panels that you've got either a blank cover or a couple tabs that are not punched out yet. That allows you for extra space if you are adding on basement outlets and you mm-hmm. want to add different items for a different circuit. You can add that on there, but always use a professional. And another tip is that if you ever do have an appliance that needs to be reset, you can simply reset the breaker. Sometimes with the dishwashers, there's an error code that appears. To reset it and bring it back to factory settings, you can turn your breaker off and back on. That'll reset the motherboard on your dishwasher.
So if you want to know more about home maintenance, we've got a great playlist here for you, and I'll see you in our next video.